Hey guys, what's up? Tyler here with PlayerSelectGaming, and we're back in the Thaumcraft guide. And today, we're going to be finishing up the tools within Thaumcraft, these little set of tools here. We're going to finish up with the Pickaxe of the Core. So if we click on that, it says, by infusing a Thaumian pickaxe with the elemental fire contained in a wand of fire, you have created a pickaxe that glows with the heat of a forge. When you mine ore blocks, there is a chance that you will receive a cluster of a native ore instead. Native ore is much easier to process and produces double the amount of metal when smelted. The pickaxe can also be used to sound out any surface you want to click against to find out what the highest value aspect is that can be found within a limited area in that direction. If shift is held, like all the other tools, this tool will lose its special properties and, yeah, it'll function like a normal pickaxe. And so to research it, you need everything that you need to actually make it within the crucible. You need metallum, visum, ignis, and instrumentum, and you need to get a Thaumian pickaxe and the wand of fire, which has to be researched already, to make the pickaxe of the core. And so we have all of our goodies in this up here. We have the pickaxe and we have the wand of fire. We have netherrack, which has ignis. We have the picks, which have instrumentum. Iron has metallum, and carrots have visum, because carrots help your eyesight. Eat your carrots, kids. And so if we take a water bucket, throw it in there. Wand's already in here. We do not need that. We need this. Put it together. It says we need 8 metallum, which would be 1 iron ingot. 8 visum, which would be 4 carats. 8 ignis, which would be 16 netherrack. And 16 instrumentum, which would be 2 diamond pickaxes. And so if we go over here, we will throw in 1 diamond pickaxe, 2... Yep, that's right. We'll throw in our 16 netherrack. And if you're wondering why can I see the aspects and you might not be able to, it's because I have on the goggles of revealing, which enable us to see that kind of stuff. I already made a video about the goggles of revealing, so you can check that out if you are curious. Throw in our iron ingot. Throw in our 4 carats. And we should be good to go. Yep, right here. Pickaxe of the core. And so, like it said, you can use it to get native ore clusters. Now, I have a bunch of native ore, not all of them, but I have tin, iron, and gold. And so we'll see if we can mine until we get one. Oh, we got one on the first try. That is what a native ore cluster looks like for tin. Get back in the house. Do not be cleaning up this mess when I'm trying to make a video. Thank you. And so sometimes you get a native ore. Sometimes you get a regular ore like that. Right there's a regular ore. Right there's a cluster. So let's see if we can get one for iron. Regular. Right there's a cluster. Regular. You have a 33% chance of getting a cluster. And we'll go with gold. Let's see if we get a gold cluster. Not yet. And we might not get one. Yep, there's one. There's a gold cluster. And that's a gold cluster. And now, if you go in here, these are all the different clusters you can get. Native iron, copper, tin, silver, lead, and gold. These are all the clusters that are available within Thaumcraft. And they do produce 2 per cluster. So if we have 1 gold ore, we'll just smelt 1 gold ore. And we'll watch that. This is exciting. This is the exciting part. We'll watch it. It should make 1 gold ingot. Right here, 1 gold ingot. Now, 1 native cluster should make 2 gold ingots. Because that's just how it works, I suppose. Which is nice. Yep, 2 gold ingots. Now, this could be used to kind of double your amount of ores you get with native ores. I use a macerator in my Feed the Beast, which also doubles the amount of ores you get with regular ores. But if you get clusters, you kind of double it. But with a macerator, it really doesn't seem like it's important to have a pickaxe of the core. If all you have is Thaumcraft in your Minecraft file, then yeah, definitely get the pickaxe of the core. But if you have something like a macerator, I really don't see it necessary, because you're going to get 2 gold, you're going to get 2 ores or ingots out of your ore no matter what. Even if that one ingot became a cluster, or this ore became a cluster, you're still going to get 2 ingots if you put it in the macerator, because it makes 2 dust. So I really don't find much of a use for it within Feed the Beast, but it has another function which can be used. If you right-click on something, it's going to show you what the kind of value is that's hidden behind rocks. Say, you don't know what's behind here. So you're mining, you want to know what's in this direction. Well, if you do this, it shows you that there's metallum in that direction. If you go here, it shows you that there's something with Solemn in that direction. If you go here, it shows you something that's with, wow, 12 crystals. So if you say, oh, we better start mining. What's behind here? Oh, look, diamond. And diamond, here we go. We got ourselves some diamond. And so if we go here, Solemn has redstone. Redstone ores have two Solemn along with a machina and something else, but Solemn is a majority. It's going to show you the majority of the aspect that's in something. Even though diamond also has the royal aspect and a couple other ones, the highest one it has is 12 of the crystal. Aspect. Wow. And iron obviously has a big metallum aspect. And so that's really all you can use the pickaxe of the core for. I really don't use it that much in my Feed the Beast series, but maybe you guys can find a use in your Minecraft series. Also, if you do enchant the pickaxe of the core with a fortune enchantment, the chance of getting a cluster goes from 33% to 75%. So that is important to keep in mind if you do want to use this for mining and you want to put fortune on it. And so that's going to wrap up this video on the pickaxe of the core. Let me know if you guys have any comments or questions or suggestions. Leave them down in the comment section below. And if you use the pickaxe of the core, what do you find the most useful about it? And if you do not use it, why not? For me, I use the macerator instead because I get the same output without having to worry about making a different tool, using up resources, and stuff like that. And so hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, remember to give it a thumbs up as it does help the channel. Also, subscribe if you enjoy. Stay in there. All he does is try to clean the place up. Just, dude, stop. You're glitching and you're making a terrible mess out of everything. Just stop. If you like the video, subscribe for more Thaumcraft, and Feed the Beast, and check out some of the other series here on this channel. So that's going to wrap it up. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll see you guys in the next video. Dude, just get out of here.